No cropping system is drought-proof, but there are things that farmers can do to mitigate the effects of a dry year. The road took us to NC State's Dr. Chris Reberg-Horton to discuss how cover crops affect water dynamics.
Water, I think, is going to be a real limiting factor over the next several decades. And particularly here in the southeast, we tend to get most of our summer precipitation in these huge rain events. And one of the things that cover crops bring to this system is they slow the movement of water across our fields. And so that we think that we have a lot of yield potential that we can garner with cover crop residues by allowing more water to soak into the soil.
Okay. Well, tell us about some of the actual work that you've done.
Sure. Well, we've worked both in corn and soybeans at this point.
Yep.
So we started with soybeans, and there we use a rye cover crop. One of the ways that we're going to get more biomass into these systems is not treating the cover crop as an afterthought, thinking of it as a key part of the production philosophy of the field. We plant our rye cover crops early, which makes a big difference. We try to plant that in October as opposed to throwing it in, you know, November, December timeframe. That does tremendous amounts for us. It's interesting what that does for water dynamics. I think, for one thing, it makes it actually drier in the spring. If you think about it, if you're going to plant a plant out there over the winter and we're going to grow it, we're going to extract water out of the soil over the season. So as you plant, we can actually be a fair bit drier than we would be. Now that can be a plus or minus depending on where you're farming. So in some areas, you know, traditional no-till agriculture without the cover crop, we can be a bit wet and cool later into the spring, and so getting into the field can be a trouble. So some drying can be a benefit on some soil types.
Okay.
On some soil types, it can be a greater concern. But then at some point in the season of that soybean, then flops. The plot that had the cover crop now becomes the wetter one because we're soaking in, again, those big rain events that come in, we're allowing greater water infiltration in those than we are in a conventional no-till setting where we don't have that residue to break up the water.
Okay.
Corn, of course, we stand even greater benefit. In our work with corn, we've done, again, that side-by-side comparison with and without the cover crop. And we can see that, you know, certainly by the time we get to silking, which can be a very important time for water dynamics, those two have flopped under our conditions. So now the one with the cover crop mulch is now wetter than the one without a cover crop mulch. Both of them done via no-till. We can actually score that. We go in and we look at our corn plots and we rate when in the morning under drought conditions does the leaf first start to curl. That's a powerful integrator telling you what the water stress on that plant is. And the plants under normal no-till are rolling hours before we see them rolling under a no-till with a massive cover crop under there. So we think that alone right there, it gives you longer period each day to grow, to set carbohydrates, to build your yield.